Gang violence in Port Elizabeth's northern areas continues to claim lives.
91 people have been killed there since January. Khoi and San activists are now calling on government to declare a state of emergency in that area. ENCA's Sandy McCowen reports.
Cleansing the space, ready for a sacred circle.
We as chiefs are willing to adopt you. We as chiefs are willing to take you in, and we want to plead to you, if you don't have a father, come to us.
An important message of support for the boys of the northern areas. Among the community leaders is former 1986 Springbok Ronald Bell. He's devastated by what's going on.
It's a heartache to see that our next generation is busy dying out before it even started. You know, when a young man of 22 or 23, maybe the only son in his family, has been brutally killed, that's the end of a bloodline.
Khoi and San leaders are trying to show the boys there's another way to live, but they feel more needs to be done to stop gang violence.
A special commission that can go around and find out what is this all about going on around us. One, the commission must come up with findings. It must be led by a judge. It must come up with findings. It must come up with recommendations.
As they eat up, many are grateful for a break from the constant violence they live in.
We don't want any more shootings to be in our areas. We want to live in peace, we want to play in peace, and want to go to school in peace. I want to tell them, all gangsters, remember that there is young people there outside who's dying in your things, not to die on the age of 9 or 10 years old. Please bring peace in our city.
Doves are brought in as the boys commit to peace.
We come honor. No more violence.
The leaders here believe if more men act as role models for the boys, peace can finally reign. Sandy McCowen, Port Elizabeth.